Greetings and welcome back to JAVACREW for a fantastic look at some rare books, rare maps, and the very rare woodcuts that they contain. Well, here we are. All right, there's the Earth, trying to go to a ball Earth from a flat Earth here. Just about 1730, probably. And we've got some other woodcuts up here on top. Now these, bear in mind, folks, this paper is basically 300 years old. There's no bleed through of the ink from one page to the next. The shadows are good, colors are good, and the detail is unbelievable. Here they are trying to get the meridian lines right and sketch things out. And here we have some another example of the woodcuts. Okay, let's go to one more book. When I tap it like that, that means I felt something in it. Now here's a great map. Look at the very top. See those meridian lines aren't quite what you would think of on a true globe. They were trying to get them right back then. Very rare. This thing may have not been open for the last 150 years. It may not have seen the light of day. I'll take a good hard look at it here for those of you, a little bit of cartography. And what a treat to be able to see this. All right. Now notice on the top, see the increments of lines 40, 60, 80, 100, and things like that. Those are how they worked their grids back then. And on the side, you can see a little bit different on the numbers. If you can, I don't know if you can see real good on your screen there. And you can see the waterways and the rivers weren't done real well. Let's go to another book. Now, Africa, they did a great job on Africa for this one. And I can't wait to go down and look at Antarctica, see if the tip of it touches down there. Some of these old maps actually had the tip of Africa touching Antarctica, and you can almost see like a little land bridge there. Again, there's no political correctness here. This was just straight map-making skills and woodcuts. Oh, it just kind of goes down to the bottom. We don't really see anything. Boy, look at the artwork here. All right, here's another one. You can see the meridian lines are starting to show a little bit. Now, this is put, as mentioned. Helmet and shields are put. We were trying to show you there, but I failed to mention it. It moves around a lot. It's mentioned in the Bible, and people argue about it to this day. I've tried to find it on all the old maps, sometimes Ethiopian type stuff. Sometimes you think you find it in Africa, sometimes you don't. Maybe somewhere it's around Libya. Who really knows? But it's just something to kind of file away if you decide you want to do this for a hobby. I'm holding my fingers down. This paper is very springy. Some of these papers will actually jump out of your hand despite being folded like this when you turn the page. It's amazing stuff. Now see at the bottom how this is being eaten away down here, decomposing? That's why I had to hold the paper down. The stuff was just, there was nothing that was sticking up. All right, look at the top now, the map maker's art. And again, you can see the lines. Okay, the inland waterways are showing a little bit. Carthage, that's a very famous deal. And again, the map making was just in its infancy back then. We're just seeing a few things. And yeah, I recognize Greece. And let's see where we go from here. Okay, down here, stadia. Anytime you see stadia on these old, like this, it's about 1730, 1700. See, there's the top up there, the meridian grid. Get this a little closer, you can see it. Now look at this. This is pretty much a flat earth deal here. There's not a lot of bending here with these. Very little bending with that meridian grid. Not everybody bought into the Pope's deal right away that we can't be in the center anymore. We have to put the sun in the center. We can't have things flat. Look at that down there. That's a heck of a nice looking map. Okay. Now see the grids on top? There's more just square grids here. Not a meridian or like a true globe. So there was a transition. Not everybody bought in, as I say, to it. The first, I guess, for the last first 5,000 years or so, people did believe flat Earth or geocentric, for the very least. And then these map makers tried to turn it away a little bit with Copernicus and Kepler and the Pope. Now here it is right here. Look at this, folks. This is an actual thing of the Earth in the center of this depiction of this device they've made, with Mars and the moon going around the outside of it. This was taught, and by the way, you can make a working model of it. Oh, look at these down here. We're almost out of time. I'm getting the signal. That one on the right, the big one on the right, let's grab that one. That just something to, yeah, this is some great woodcut stuff. Some of this is not much bigger than my thumbnail. Okay, he's got something going on. I can't, hands are only, oh, he's only got four fingers on his hand, not five. That was it. There's a weird hand. See, those hands are not good-looking hands, are they? Everything's planned with woodcuts. On the right, of course, is the angel we've looked at before, holding back a lion. There's the phoenix bird getting ready to do his mischief. And then the top is, that's typically a Jesuit or Catholic thing when you see a phoenix bird with the light rays. 1688, that last one. Okay, let's grab some more. We only have some more. This feels funny here. Kind of a little bit more moisture content, maybe. I can't tell. Pages. Okay. Oh, yeah, we got a good one here. Looks like a nice old book. The focus, I apologize, I'm down deep in an archive here that's real weird lighting. And it's actually a privilege to be down in a place like this where you can share all that. Now, look at this one. This is a little newer, but this is going to... I mean, let's just face it. They used to call black people something different back in the days of these books. And so we'll try to be cautious here. But we're going to find some black people hidden in some of this artwork. Now, there's pure occult right here. There's said to be one black person down there. See that seashell kind of looking deal? And it goes right up to a full-on occult, full-on Masonic lodge right here, baby. The obelisk, and up it goes to the top. And I'm not in, you know, I mean, Scottish tourists, Scottish Rite, Freemasonry. Boy, this is it right there. This is how they, I mean, it's nice artwork. Here are the maps. You got to be very careful. But despite being folded for 100 or 200 years, there's still spring. You'll see this map spring right back again. Unbelievable paper and ink. Hand-colored. See those colors there? All done by hand. Not on a printing press back then. If you were going to do conspiracy theories, you could take maps like this with the Freemasons and see what they were up to, perhaps where the rituals were held. I mean, who knows? But there's a lot going on there. Be very careful. Always careful of people that you come into their handles with treasures, just like I just did. Easily fold the map in. Okay, now this is very rich. Now look at this thing. If I put my thumb across the top window there, there's supposed to, said to be a black person down there. I just have to go by lore or whatever. And we'll go up a little bit up there. And look at the... Can you imagine cutting wood? It'd take a man a long... So there's my thumbnail, just for a size gun. Look at the detail on this thing. I wish you could see it with a magnifying glass. And the ink doesn't seem to have faded or bled through at all. A true craftsmanship. Now look at this one here. The same picture. I'm going to blow it really up. Look at this thing. You can see people back there behind the windows. Oh, boy. Now here's something. A man and wife depicted as being something coming on them from the top. I don't know. I don't know if this is a cult or if this is an apocalyptic scenario. Now this shows we have a horizontal printing and kind of a horizontal picturing as well. I'll let you take a look. See the bottom part there? There's a little bit kind of a... Now, here's what the black... Do you see black people hiding in the lower right area down there? Well, this is supposed to be them down there hiding down... Or not hiding, but camping down there. You're supposed to be able to see them. And let's get down lower right down that area. And kind of a little campground thing in the back. Yeah, kind of look to see it. All right, now here's a torn up... I don't like them torn up like this. People are careless or... But I'll show you how... Watch this thing jump out of my hand. I'm going to show you how much life is in this paper, and then we'll put the book back. I didn't find it like this, by the way. This is the way somebody else left it. But I'm just going to let this snap kind of over by itself and let you see. After 200 years, let it go. There. Look at that. Unbelievable, like a spring. Let me go ahead and put this back here properly with a very gentle, very easy touch. But these papers are absolutely unreal. Somebody ought to do some scientific work on it. A real treat that we're getting a chance to enjoy here. Well, let's look at the outside here. They sometimes use the word Mick, which is a derogatory term for Irish people back in the day this book was made. But these were not Irish. These were Scottish people. Down the lower left, you see the harp. It's not a true 10-string harp, but 10-string harps are found in the Bible. And then, of course, the bass line here. Now, this next one, sometimes I have to go through all these pages just to get one or two woodcuts. It's sad, but true. Now, I'm not complaining, but just let you know, some of these things are stamped to be thrown away or discarded by, you know, 100 years ago they didn't want them around. Somebody helped. Thank goodness somebody didn't follow rules, and they saved these treasures, priceless treasures. I know these are not maybe everyone's cup of tea for Christianity. There's a lot of Catholicism, Jesuits, Masonicism stuff here, but look, we're seeing some history. some woodcuts, some fantastic maps, and getting a sense of what it was. Now, here's something. Look at this. A sun coming down like a UFO driven by three bolts. On the left, there's a church. On the right, there's a phoenix bird on a thing. The numbers, I mentioned this before, the numbers on top are a different font. Let me grab the Bible real quick about the sun coming down. Here it is. The sun coming down with heat and scorching. That might have been 2 Peter, the verse maybe they were trying to tell us. I don't know. Let's get back to this thing. Now, on the left, see those six little round deals? I'm going to go to each one, just snap a picture of each one and blow it up because we're running out of time here. I can't do it justice, but here they are. This is your new George Bush, New World Order, skull and bones, crossbones stuff here. You're going to be seeing in a minute. It's been going on forever. Long time. Okay, here she is. There's Geronimo's skull. They lay down with the skull. They got the little, on top, a little demonic thing. And here it is, skull and bones, man. And she looks like a distraught witch, doesn't she? Okay, next one, this guy's looking up at a chemtrail or something. That's not a normal cloud, but there's something going on up there. So he's looking up for, now here it is. She's having to lay down like a skull and bones ritual, one hand under her right buttocks, the other left hand on top of her pelvis. And here you go, George Bush, New World Order. John Kerry, thanks a lot, guys. What else we have here? Oh, yeah. Now, see, look, the hand of Jesus Christ, his left hand, is up by that all-seeing eye. That's a bastard. That's not right. When Jesus was crucified right here, that little sign says, this is Jesus, the King of Kings. On his left and right, indeed, were thieves, but on his left hand was the bad thief, the reprobate. On his right hand, the right thief. So you would have had that. That's just complete opposite of what it should be, that depiction you saw of that three all-seeing eyes in a triangle of Jesus. Grab your Bibles and look at these woodcuts. There's all kinds of signals and things to... Here's probably a new initiate wanting to come in, find out about skull and bones. Yeah, man, and they're going to... You know, you got the money. And here's something... this is just to show how... Oh, look at the date on that. Getting in that early, early 1700s. Sometimes they use four different fonts on the front title pages. It's very effective. I mean, this is... You have to remember, this was like an iPad back in those days for somebody who could barely read. Having a book like anything like this was something. Now look at, this is a big one. I'm going to take my fist and just tap a little, just hold for size. These are very heavy books. Time is running out, folks. I'm going to have to just grab one or two here. Let us take a look. I really wish we had a lot more time. I really do. JAVACREW is always happy to have you come by. Just look at this here. Just piles and piles. Some of this stuff, I don't want to say priceless. This isn't the real, real kind of stuff you'd mortgage your home for, but there's some nice, nice samples in here. All right, let's get ready and pop one open. This has a funny feel to it, like the humidity's been adjusted. The ink looks a little darker on here. Go ahead, fleur-de-lis on it. Kind of know where this is going to go after a while once you see the example. Look at the thin, gee whiz. Just all the life is leached out of that paper, improperly stored. Probably in the States. Oh, look at this. What in the world? What is going on inside that circle? I don't know. Up here, looks just like kind of I don't see any real mischief there. Okay, just some artwork. There might be something there, maybe if possible, phoenix head on top. Here's a guy playing with a fish to the right. He's playing a tune. He's got a dead fish suspended upside. Look at the fish's face. It looks like the Pope's hat upside down. Oh, whenever I tap it, that means my hand felt something. After a while, you can train your hands and tell if there's a hidden map in these things. You really can. You wouldn't believe it, but I've got to that level just by sheer. I found all kinds of maps in these things put in by the manufacturer. Now, what's this? I don't know. Anyway, if you take your thumb and just pull it up like this, you can feel a map in there. Up right there. You got to be real, just like dealing blackjack. And there it is, baby. Oh, boy. There's the treasure. That map is this thing. Most people don't even know they're in there. Go right. I'm going to open it very gently. It could have been, you know, a couple hundred years it has since it's been opened. This one may have been opened in the last decade. Whoa, look at the spring in that paper, will you? Wow. Okay, there it is. What a treasure. What a map. You could make a copy of this, and that would be something to have on your wall. Africa, I'm always wanting to see if it gets down to you know where, Antarctica. You might say, why you worry about that? Well, these flat earth people have me thinking about stuff, about land bridges and about government deceptions and things like that. Okay, there we are on the top. Put, land of put, we've talked about earlier. Sometimes you can try to find it up in these areas. Usually it's on the right side more. That's not over here by Spain, but it's over in the right land of put. It gets put on different areas. Now let's see the meridian marks, the gauging on the numbers there. Gosh, they're small. I'll let you look at it yourself. Okay, just getting a very, very sense here what they've given us. And what a treasure. These are real treats. Stadia. You know, you're back there again. Here's a little something there. Just a design where the inland waterways are shown a little bit. Real easy to wreck a ship with something with a map like this. You got to be darn careful back then. All right, just I'm going to show a few more maps for the people who've been hanging around for maps, and we'll get on to something a little bit more. You're going to find out there's energy. Oh, there's Hercules. Hercules is the guy's name on this map here. So, you know, that's an old one. For the people who like maps, I'll just show a quick handful of them here. Then you're going to find, and I want to let you down early, as we get to the newer stuff, like the late 1700s, early 1800s, the energy just goes out of our presentation here. This is a funny feeling. Jesus, things tore up. When you're a guest, you never monkey with your stuff or look for a hidden compartment. It's considered bad form. I have found stuff, but you always leave it alone. What do you got going here? Oh, there's a Mason Frey. You got the Freemason sign. Oh, yeah. Possible occultic. All right, let's get this paper up. This is really thin. Jeez, it's hardly... This book is not taken care of properly. Oh, okay. We got some things down here. A ship. Now, the ship... There's a lot to these ships, the way the sails, the way the mast, the way the rigging is in, how many gun ports on the side. We're just going to go ahead and look at this for artists, for artwork's sake right now. We're not going to go through a big deal. But this is nice, a well-balanced little ship. And I think we've got time for a couple more books here. Oh, boy. Whenever you see this, that usually means at one time or another a bunch of people got into it, maybe at a university a couple hundred years ago or something. There's really nothing... Is there anything under here? No, there's not even a woodcut under there. There was something going on at the time. Here's one shot through with a mold type of thing. But I want you to see this ink. They're starting to get realistic now. The inks are realistic. Not the Phoenix bird is not by the guy's face like on the other map. Here it's getting more modern as we look at England, old England. I'm talking about the part where they were rumored to have giants and they had old shoes. We'll look at some of the old shoes here in a minute. Coin depictions. I don't know much about the coins, but I enjoy looking at them. Some of the coins we see, anytime you see someone holding a spear in England with that coin or in Rome or Italy, there's typically quite a story. Britain, they call it Britannia or Brit-tin. Tin the metal, of course. If you look at one of the other, okay, now look at this here. A little crescent on a standard holding the spear. That's supposed to be a female. That has a lot of history on a coin like this. All right, one more look here, and then we're going to go ahead and zip through a couple of coins. And this paper's washed a little bit. Well, go ahead and read this. I'm going to just let you read a little bit of it to get a sense of how they explain about the coins. You may never have a chance again to read something like this. You can just speed read through it a little bit. Look about the specimens and Britannia and the spear, how the spear is held, the symbology, and certain things are omitted. Can just pick up a few words, perhaps. Hope you can get some enjoyment out of this. Okay. All right. We see a little bit more here. Coin depictions. And here's the guy. He's got the helmet. He doesn't have much of a standard, does he? His spear is not very good either. All right, here's part of like Liverpool and Newcastle where they were building foundations and stuff. I just put it in there because here's the perspective, how they used a perspective to show animals of the wrong size on purpose to make your eye look farther down the road. They did some things. They did what they could. Here's about when they unearthed some excavations. Now look at this thing. Where's the Phoenix bird? Do you see the Phoenix bird on top up there? That's over and over again. A little bit of occultic imagery there. You can see it. Now, this next stuff, not right now, we're starting to lose energy. We're getting to the stuff that's the late 1700s, maybe even a little bit of early 1800s, and it's just like, we're out of that golden era, that golden age. I do want to show you some solar jewelry. If you look at some of the other stuff I've done on the site, there's one about solar, it's a ghost. soul, how you can use a ring or an amulet, or not an amulet, but something hanging on your neck to actually tell the time. And you may want to take a look at some of the jewelry. I'll show you a couple rings here in a minute. One's just got a little occultic thing on it, which you see everywhere. The other could... Now, what's we got here? We got a crescent and a cross, something excavated. Looks more like a chicken than a phoenix bird. There's stories here that it just... Who knows? Now, I have to go through... There's Dagon, the fish god, apparently. That's always a reoccurring theme. I'm going to go through just a few of these fragments. I know you got a lot of you guys are losing interest now because it's not the real old rare treats, the rare maps, the rare books, the rare woodcuts. But there's some stuff. Look at there. The guy on the left doesn't look. Looks almost non-human. I guess there's a different kind of a face. Now, these rings up here. Look at the second one from the left. And I'm not saying these are solar rings, but on the other... If you want to scour my site here at JAVACREW, I do have solar rings. The actual ones have been unearthed that used to tell time have a little hole in it. Well, there you can see right here. And then I'll come back to the rings in a second, just in case we have to leave here. At least I have a chance to look. Okay, that thing on the left, that's a little idol. That's a little demonic thing. You see that in Australia years ago. That ring right there, set up right, you could make that possibly tell this. If you held it just right, get a little shadow off of it. Here's a guy got a bow and arrow set type of thing. And then these are sometimes called household idols or household gods. Folks, we've got to go. This is the oldest shoes I've ever seen on any JAVACREW I've ever done. Take a look at these things as we close out. You know the old Bible verse, how beautiful are the feet of those who bring good news. Look at that. Now, there's not much of a toe box in there. Your toes get kind of pinched off. The heel, a little bit of support there for your Achilles. Anyway, take care. We've simply got to leave the archive area here. Hey, thanks for stopping by. Always a pleasure to have you come by. Maybe we can get one more of these in for 2017. And you know what? Let's just have a great year ahead. Take care. Peace to all of you. And don't forget on the site now in the upper right-hand corner. You could do it right now. Just put your mouse in the upper right-hand corner or stop it, and there'll be a little white dot that YouTube puts in now that has some additional information. Peace to all of you. God bless, and bye for now.